Thank you. Yeah. Hello. Nice to meet you. So it's a great honor for me to have the presentation in TED here. So I am a professor and a CEO of the Cyberdyne. And today I brought the robotic health systems. And today I would like to explain about these things. And the title of this talk is "As Robotics to Suit You." Okay. So there are two types of. This one is the world's first cyborg-type robot systems. And there are two types of robot control systems. The one is the cybernetic voluntary control systems based on the bioelectrical signals from the brain to the peripherals. Okay. And other one is the cybernetic autonomous control systems. Okay. And so please see this one. So if we wish to move our bodies at the time, brain generates intentions. And these intentions transmitted through the peripheral as a bioelectrical signals, very, very faint, small bioelectrical signals. And these robots uses these bioelectrical signals. And these signals are transmitted to here, and the sensor systems, sensor pad on the surface of the body detects the signals, and computer analyzes these signals. And finally, computer drives the robots. So the robots works instead of the human's bodies, okay? And by using these technologies, we are trying to develop the innovation technologies for healthy and long-lived societies. And these technologies, in order to realize the physiological and physical, cognitively, and social, psychological, social support technologies. And basic technology or core technologies are such kind of robotic technologies. And these technologies are also based, consist of physiological and physiological and physical support technologies. And that vital sensing or nerve connection technologies or regenerative medicine. And by using these technologies, I would like to promote, develop the life support technologies for observing and keeping the safety of the aged peoples and societies. Okay, and I developed these systems in order to enhance and expand and support the human's abilities. Okay, and they are the Prime Minister of Japan. So of course you know the Japanese political condition is a little bit complicated. So okay, so he was Prime Minister of Japan, Mr. Koizumi, and he was also a Prime Minister of Japan, Mr. Abe, and he was also a Prime Minister of Japan, Mr. Aso. And fortunately, this council is a very important council. In this council, Japanese science and directions are decided, okay? And of course, you know, last September, we have the new politics, okay? So, fortunately, they also, all of them, consider about these human assistive technologies. Of course, you know that, so biotechnologies or nanotechnologies are one of the very, very important to challenge fields. And they recognize the importance of the such kind of human assistive technologies. So the governments now strongly promoted to develop these fields, okay. And now we have the good collaboration with the governments, and so foreign countries, organizations. And now I would like to establish the high-tech medical hubs in the, Europe or US or Middle East or Asian or Japan. I separated the five regions, okay? And I would like to promote the education or trainings or promote marketing and businesses. And now I'm looking for the good partners. Okay. 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 Yeah. So fortunately, last October, we started to distribute these systems for the other commercial models. Okay, and now these systems are working in the, some of the hospitals or care centers, and every HAL system has the communication systems through the internet. So the these data are gathered to the in the database centers in order to analyze this analyze the motions. Okay. And this one is one of the actual applications. Okay. He is a Parkinson's disease patient. Okay. He cannot stand up and work without our system during 2 years. Okay. Even the staff in this care center are surprised to see it. Okay. And he is an incomplete spinal cord injury patient. He can move his legs only a little, approximately like this. And now he's trying to how to drive the robot suit. And now medical doctors explaining the how to stand up, okay? And now he is trying to, yes, stand. Of course, he cannot stand up and walk by himself. And sit down, okay? He continued to use it. And same day, okay? Same day. And finally, he strongly wished to use the walkers. And now he's walking. But outside it became dark. Okay. Same day, okay? And finally, he also strongly wished to use a cane, okay, stick. So you can find some of the strange feelings. Everybody uses a mask. So even the Japanese person has a smile faces, okay, in the mask. Okay. Okay. And it's a similar keywords. Okay. And this one is amazing technologies. He don't have the left side leg, okay? He lost it, okay? He can bend this artificial leg, cybernetic leg, according to his intentions, okay? Bend and extend, amazing. Bend and extend it. And finally, okay, he can walk very smoothly, okay? Now he is trying to climb up the stairs. Thank you, okay? Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. And they are the queen of king of the Spain and the empress of Japan. They visited our laboratories. And fortunately, I was selected the top researchers of Japan. And now I strongly promoted these fields. Okay. So now we are preparing the some of the branches in other worlds, international satellites. Okay, and this here is Akihabara. Okay, so now in Japan they are working by using. So this one is a little bit jokey. So, but the photo is similar to the Beatles photos. Okay. Okay. And now, okay. From Homo sapiens to HAL sapiens. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. Thank you so much.